My name is Owei, and this is one of my final year projects in NTU during 2015-16. So it's 2 years ago FYP. I will be talking through my project for the smart IT system. So today our content will be from point 1 to point 4 is the concept and ideas. From point number 5 to 7 is the hardware and the software. And point 8 is cost benefit analysis. 9 is future recommendation and conclusion. So why do I want to do a smart lighting system? The reason is I want to do something related to smart nation. And for example, in NTU, every time when I reach lab around 8 o'clock, only can see one person like this. One person over there turn all the light.
Aww.
I can see there's a lot of light wastage. So how to improve? I will evaluate more on it. And this is the cost wise. Currently, the smart lighting system for one whole set will cost about $399. Mm-hmm. I will do something related to IoT, like energy monitoring. So that's my education journey. So basically, I've done my third FYP over here. So for the first two, I'm studying computer network and clean energy. So my last FYP is related to this why I study and apply to it.
Whoa.
So the objective is to use wireless control through intranet, use smartphone to do apps, use apps to do control, and build an affordable smart lighting system, and also energy saving, and able to do monitoring of energy, and last is easy to maintain and troubleshoot. So these are the overview of the projects. Basically, the very important thing is you need a router because this router will connect all the devices. So how you do control, you can basically can use card to turn on the lights, or you want to use smartphone, no issue. So for lighting, they basically have two types of lighting. One is more of commercial, like fluorescent lights, LED, and home base is like normal LED lights at home. And the last is the energy monitoring. For furthermore, I will show you the video first. It's better, easy to understand.
Thank you.
My internship company, just like they are doing lighting control. So this is a very good opportunity for me to do FYP. So for my company, my boss have a big issue. The issue is he got this motion detector for most of the lighting. So the motion detector is very useful in terms that it can do a lot of setting, like distance setting, whole time setting. And if you want to do setting right, first of all, for over here right, you need to do the micro switch. So over here is the truth table for all the switching. So if, let's say if I have one or two right, it's okay for me to switch it like this, no issue. What if I got 10 or even 100? I'm not going to switch one by one, no way, man. So for my solution, I propose to it is to use a wireless setting control. So based on this, I use a Bluetooth and can do all the setting over here. So for the lighting control, I have these two versions. One is iMega. iMega is to do, first over here is to do the settings of the smart lighting system. And this ESP266 module is to on and off the lighting. So for advantage of the device is that this device is, I can say, is a plugger and plugging module. What does it mean? For example, this relay is spoiled. I just plug out. I just change this module. After that, I just replace it. So in terms of in terms of why, so this will be much more cheaper, affordable. Because if, let's say, one module is spoiled, right, you need to change the whole module. You just only change this part of module. So this one is iMini, it's a smaller version. So this iMini is more on just only light control. And this is more useful, let's say you want to install at home. So in terms of control, right, we are using the IP address to either turn on and off. So for this, it's very troublesome. The reason is, if let's say I got 10, then I cannot clean one by one. So over here is I make it into a multiple control. So over here, just like you can see, there's a lot of lighting that you can control in one shot. So besides that, this device has this RFID tag to catch the card to turn on the lighting. So for home apps, I'm using Apps Inventor too. And the card access light control, okay, how does it work and how good is this features? Okay, the whole idea is, let's say 8 o'clock, one person comes. You tap the card and the light will turn on. Second person come, you tap the card and this light will turn on. So overall, this will save even more energy and reduce unnecessary energy. So for IoT monitoring, I'm using a current sensor over here, you can see. And once it captures the data and update to the cloud, so you can use a web browser to see all the monitoring, all the energy level of power. So for cost benefit analysis, so this is a normal vision curve for the office. So example for here, SSC is from 8 o'clock to around 6 o'clock. The total number over here is the total number of people. So I make it a sample size of 5 people. So you can see over here, the energy wise for the smart lighting will be more than conventional system because it requires an additional energy for the circuit board. But however, you can see at 8 o'clock, let's say one person come, right?
the energy will be much more lesser compared to the conventional model, which means you over here you just only turn on one light. If, let's say if you reach until 1 p.m., you turn on the light. And however, this energy is much more to the conventional model, but doesn't matter. But overall, the whole curve, right, I consume lesser energy compared to a conventional model. So these are the total costs, and it costs around $107. So the payback, this is around 39 days, and the amount of energy saved will be 49%. So Conclusion, has successfully implemented the smart lighting system in the industrial office. The system is able to do wireless control within intranet networks. For the project, it reduced the cost compared to a commercial product and able to develop IoT monitoring system. So for the future recommendation, I hope that the circuit can implement into PCB and in a very small size. And the energy monitoring system are able to make full use of data to do some lighting settings and able to view it using apps. So another implementation is using voice control like Google Assistant, like, hey Google, turn on the lights, okay? And doesn't really need to use our handphone apps or our web browser to do control. And for, just like you see, using an ESP8266 version 1, but now currently it's more advanced. Yeah. I prefer you use Wemos because it will be much more easier to do programming. So other than that, FYP didn't end until, during that time didn't end in the school. I also take part in competition in NTU for the taste challenge. This is my participation, and I also will move on to Schneider Electric. And again, my projects are all first runner out during the year. So for now, I got how many? 2 minutes. Okay, maybe I'll show you one of my implementation after a few years later, which is the Google Assistant.
Hey Google, turn on the fan.
Turns on the device.
So this is one of the way, right, you use voice to
hey,
do control.
Google, turn off the fan.
Turning off the device.
And you can ask any question that you want.
Hey Google, what's the time now?
It's 10:23.
Hey Google, what's the temperature right now?
27.
Hey Google, what's the temperature for Taipei?
26.
Hey Google, sing a song.
Okay, thank you.